In this video, I will show you how to make your own switch mode power supply by using the parts from recycled. Step by step. This is the circuits diagram. And the values of parts are only for reference. To input AC 230 volt from here, through EMI filter and bridge rectifier, then a filter again for smoothing out the pulse voltage after bridge rectifier. Finally DC 325 volt will be there. The circuit as whole was made on PCB board, which I cut it off from a broken TV. The AC input socket is here. EMI filter. Bridge rectifier with heatsink attached. And a capacitor with larger value for smoothing DC is here. This is the DC positive for 325 volt. That white wiring color is the DC negative. Or hot earth. DC 325 volt on the left at the low part of diagram is from the top and right of the circuits diagram. The output is DC 5 volt to DC 24 volt. However, maximum DC 20 volt will be limited in this DIY practice. This portion is the snub circuit, which is made by DIY, consists of a capacitor, two diodes, and three resistors. This is a ferrite core transformer. I've got the one here, which is from a recycled computer power supply. It has been tested, and okay. Apart from two diodes, full circuit is made by DIY. The parts and components soldered on a small PCB. This is not a transformer. It is an inductor. Or choke in the other ward. Two Shockley diodes soldered together in series, and they have been bolted on a heat sink. This is anode and that is cathode terminal. Their maximum current is 10 amperes. The DC sampling power module is here. It cost a few dollars and has been bolted on a frame as a heat sink. There are four wires in the different colors from the module, which are yellow, blue, red, and black. They are all marked from the diagram. In addition, the brackets, power cables, 3-pin socket, and others, etc. All things here will be connected and installed on this wood board. Here we go, all done. The AC 230 volt socket is here. That EMI filter circuit board, plus the DC sampling power module with its heatsink, bolted together and secured on the wood board. This is the components for the snub circuit. And that is the ferrite transformer. The DC 325 volt is connected to this terminal on the transformer. However, the red wire from the DC sampling module is connected to the other terminal on the transformer. The anode terminal from the combined Shockley diode is connected to two terminals on the center from the transformer's secondary. The output DC negative, or earth, is connected to the secondary's common earth terminal from the transformer. The combined Shockley diode with its heatsink is secured here. The DIY secondary filter components are there. Those are the brackets for the output, DC positive and negative. Yellow wire is arranged along this way, which is the feedback wire from the output positive to the module. Blue wire is on that way, which is the earth wire from the output negative to the module. Red wire arranged along this way, which is the transformer's one of terminal wires that is connected to the anode terminal from snub circuit's diode to the module. Black wire is on that way, which is the hot earth wire to the module. plugging the AC power cable into its socket, but not to switch AC power on yet. A multimeter has been selected to DC 200 volt position, and its probes have been connected to the output positive and negative accordingly. Switched the power on. A LED indicated the power has been on. DC 12.3 volt indicated by the multimeter, which is the output voltage from this DIY power supply. By using this screwdriver to adjust the output voltage, turning clockwise will increase the output voltage, and watching out the multimeter's reading. The output voltage is going to reach 20 volt now, and stop there. By turning the screwdriver anti-clockwise, the output voltage is decreasing. It has reduced to 4.6 volt, and stop here. Now adjusting to just over at 12 volt, then stop there. As a load, two of 12 volt LED connected in parallel. A black jumper wire has been connected to the DC negative bracket. Leave a red jumper wire out for a moment. Switched the power on. Then a LED is lit. Now you've known how to DIY in unique switch mode power supply by utilizing the ones recycled. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe if you have enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.